What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode on TUGGtv. First time on the channel, we do all things metal and all things guitar. So give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon for more updates from us. A while back, I made a video which spoke about how VSTs could potentially all move into a subscription model and how there is some sort of sense and logic to it, both for those who make VSTs as well as us who use them. And that idea sort of came through when I was reviewing the STL amphub, and I saw this, that it is available at, you know, as low as $10 a month. That's less than 750 rupees a month. Less than that, in fact, if you go for the annual subscription. So I didn't really do a review about amphub at the time. Since you guys requested me, I thought, why not walk you through the UI tones and share some thoughts like I normally do. Now, coming back to the offering itself, you also have the option for a 10-day trial. I definitely recommend that you go for the 10-day trial, whether you want to buy it or not, at least to experience it. What you have to keep in mind is if you are going in for this, it uses the iLock license manager, so you'll have to create an account there, which also might double up as your STL account, which also means you will have to input card details. And those card details by default are going to have the auto renewal on. So should you choose to not continue with this, you might want to go to your account. You can do it sort of in advance as well and turn off that auto renew option. And of course, like I've mentioned in the past, you don't have to buy everything in subscription. You have the option to go perpetual and buy out, you know, amp models outright. You will have to start by buying out the default player, which comes in at about $40, gives you all this stuff as part of it. And then if you want more amps and pedals, you go to the collection and then you have a wide variety to choose from. You know, dual rectifiers, 808 overdrives, orange. Famous amps are kind of interesting, you know, nice offering over there, some Marshalls and all of that. And if you look at it, the pricing model works very similar to that of ML Sound Lab. So you got amps for like $40-$50 odd. But over a period of time, they're going to keep releasing more stuff and you're going to keep buying more stuff. And in the long run, it's going to work out not so cheap. So that's what it has to offer. And in terms of the UI itself, this is what it looks like. If you are somebody who's been using stuff by STL Tones, it is a very, very familiar feel. Input, output, there's a noise gate inbuilt, the tuner for you to go ahead and tune. Ignite's Emissary, great amp. It's been available for free for quite some time and it's a default offering over here. This is where you can go ahead and choose your pedal. So you got a compressor, overdrive, preamp and all of that stuff. Amps, as mentioned, you can select it over here. They also have one bass amp. Maybe they will be changing this or adding more as we go forward. But this amp is more so towards the jazzy slash vintage style. So if you're trying to do heavier stuff, probably want to use something else. But as mentioned, various other options, plenty of Marshalls. There's also an Engels, the amp that I used in my cover, along with one of the Marshall offerings and Emissary as we spoke about. Next up is the IR loader. So you've got some default IRs that come with this. You have a blending option, a decibel meter, and then you have all these knobs which allow you to change where you want to place the microphone, the distance, the angle, high pass filter, low pass filter, resonance, and all of that stuff. If you've been using NAD IR, it's a very, very familiar feel. An option to invert the phase as well is there over here. And should you want to use your own custom stuff, while I don't see an option to load up stuff within this, you can disconnect it and then go ahead and use an external loader and load up what you want. Finally, of course, place for you to add all your effects, so be it chorus, flanger, reverb, all that stuff, it's available here. In terms of some of the presets that are there, I must say that they are very, very workable and ready to go. That is in a way important to me because I've mentioned this multiple times in the past. My definition of a good VST is the ability to do more with less. And this sort of fits the bill. So anyway, while we're going to look at individual tones, let me just fire up some of these presets, starting off with this Ignite amps, which is just stock, just loaded. Let's see what all of it sounds like. Anyway, coming back to tones, what I'm going to do now is I have turned off any of the pedals and effects and all of that, and I'm just going to be playing a sort of standard clean and then distorted riff on all of these amps in their default settings. And I'm just using this standard, you know, IR setting that is available with it to keep a level playing field. So let's see what those tones sound like and make sure you're using a good set of headphones or speakers to pick up on the differences. Thank you. Okay, so that's that, and that is STL Tone's amphub for you. Would you consider it or not? And should you consider it, would you prefer buying this stuff outright, or would you prefer going for a subscription sort of method? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if there is something else you want to see, hit us up in the comments and, you know, we'll be glad to work on it. Anyway, with that, I come to the end of this video. This is TUGGtv signing off for now. The cops are roaming in this area for some reason. So I will see you in the next one. And until next time,